I know why you made that vow to your father. I found the letters you wrote to him as a child, and I read them.
Bridgerton premiered on Netflix in December to tremendous acclaim. Phoebe Dynevor and Regé-Jean starred in the hit historical drama, which was based on Julia Quinn's romance novels and brought viewers to a world dominated by social gala, family strife, and juicy gossip. So, how much do we know about the third season of Bridgerton? Here's what you need to know. The drama, which was created by Shonda Rhimes, was renewed for a second season in January. In the season one, it follows Daphne Bridgerton, portrayed by Phoebe Dynevor as she negotiates the 1813 marriage market. Daphne is the Bridgerton family's eldest daughter, and she is under obligation to continue in her parents' footsteps by securing a true love match. Lady Whistledown, Julie Andrews, the mystery narrator, begins to pass judgments on Daphne against the background of London's high society as her older brother shuts out all her potential suitors. The duo establishes a mutually beneficial pact to pretend to be engaged after meeting Simon, Duke of Hastings, played by Regé-Jean, a dedicated bachelor. When sparks ignite between them, though, things take a hot turn. But what's with the hype of season 3? Yes, you may think we're getting ahead of ourselves because Bridgerton season 2 hasn't even finished filming, but genuine fans will know that Netflix has confirmed both Bridgerton season 3 and Bridgerton season 4, which is great news for everyone. Then again, there are a lot of Bridgerton siblings to get through, so it's no surprise that there's a lot more to come. We're clutching our pearls for all the havoc Lady Whistledown is yet to deliver. Given that this is Netflix's biggest series ever, the romantic period drama will follow the narrative of one key family member per season based on Julia Quinn's novel, on which the show is based. While season 3 will not air for some time because the cast is now filming season 2 in London, fans can still look forward to more Bridgerton to come. Rhimes is excited to continue with the series. Shonda Rhimes, the creator of Grey's Anatomy, Scandal, and now Bridgerton, has issued a statement expressing her enthusiasm for the next seasons. Rhimes stated that she knew Julia Quinn's exquisite Bridgerton series would attract a viewing audience from the first time she read it. However, without the numerous major contributions of the complete Shondaland team, the evolution of this adaptation would not be an accomplishment. She went on to say that the two-season renewal is a great vote of confidence in their work, and she is grateful to have Netflix as a collaborator and a creative partner. The executive producer of the show and she are hyped at the prospect of continuing to bring the exquisite world of Bridgerton to a global audience. What will the third season of Bridgerton entail? Quinn's third book, Bridgerton, An Offer from a Gentleman, concentrates on Benedict Bridgerton's narrative, which has a Cinderella-like quality to it. According to the book's synopsis, this year's most sought-after invitation must definitely be that of Bridgerton Masquerade Ball, to be held Monday next. Will a lucky young girl take advantage of the mystery of a masquerade night to snag one of the available bachelors? Sophie Beckett seems to have no clue she'd be slipping into Lady Bridgerton's legendary masquerade ball, much less that Prince Charming would be there too to greet her. Sophie, despite being the daughter of an earl, had been relegated to the role of servant by the contemptuous stepmother. But she felt like royalty that night, spinning in the strong arms of the debonair and devastatingly attractive Benedict Bridgerton. Despite this, she understands that all enchantments must come to an end. However, Sophie underestimated Benedict's tenacious heart. He has pledged to discover and marry his mystery miss, knowing that this is one opportunity for a fairy tale love. What will the third season of Bridgerton be like in comparison to the first two? Quinn's novels do not include Genevieve Delacroix, the seamstress Benedict lusts after in season 1. However, there appears to be more to the tale in the series, so we're looking forward to seeing how the character develops and whether she complicates Benedict and Sophie's growing connection and adds an edge to this prospective love triangle. This one has a strong Cinderella vibe about it. Season 3 cast of Bridgerton. If Netflix follows Quinn's book series order and the tale focuses on Benedict's search for love, we may expect to see all of the Bridgertons return in season 3, with Luke Thompson reprising his role as Benedict Bridgerton. Violet, the widowed Viscountess and mother of 8 siblings, is played by Ruth Gemmell. The 8 Bridgertons' children will be played by the usual ones: Jonathan Bailey as Anthony, the oldest and wisest Bridgerton sibling, Luke Thompson playing the role of handsome Benedict, Luke Newton as Dashing Colin, Phoebe Devenna playing the role of the most beautiful Daphne, Claudia Jesse as smart Eloise, Ruby Stokes playing cheerful Francesca, Will Tilston as the young master Gregory, and Florence Hunt as little Hyacinth. The names are all given to the siblings in the alphabetical order of the parents. Of course, Julie Andrews' Lady Whistledown will make an appearance. Otherwise, is Bridgerton still Bridgerton? If Anthony's marriage goes well in season 2, we might see Kate played by Simone Ashley, Edwina's younger sister, with whom Anthony falls in love, and Edwina Sharma return played by Charitra Chandran. Regé-Jean Page, who played the Duke of Hastings, Simon Bassett, has lately indicated that he will not be returning to the show for season 2. Rhymes previously told THR that she was just thrilled at the prospect of being able to create a whole great love story with a conclusion, rather than 14 more reasons why the pair can't be together, or, frankly, having Regé stand in the background of someone else's romance. Bridgerton's second season will also feature new cast members, including Simone Ashley of Sex Education. These casting changes for the show's second season suggest that there may be more changes in the future. However, we don't know if the cast will remain the same between seasons 2 and 3 at this time. Those who have read the Bridgerton books promise that whatever the producers have in store for us in the next season will be even more steamy than the first. What is the release date for Bridgerton season 3? And can you see a trailer? As you may expect, filming for season 2 is now ongoing. So this is still a way off. So no, it's still too early to announce a season 3 release date or trailer, with season 2 filming beginning in May 2021 and a projected release date of early 2022. Season 3 of Bridgerton is unlikely to arrive until late 2022 or early 2023. What is in store for Bridgerton season 3? Quinn's writings will continue to be a source of inspiration for the show. While Bridgerton the series does not exactly match Quinn's books, it does follow the fundamental premise. The Viscount Who Loved Me, the second book in the series, will be the basis for the show's second season. There's no assurance that the third season will follow Julia Quinn's third book, but it's a strong possibility. The first season followed the events of the first book, and the second season will follow the events of the second book. Sophie, on the other hand, gets to get into Lady Bridgerton's masquerade party, where she meets her Prince Charming. She feels like royalty as she swells in Benedict Bridgerton's arms, but is this a one-night stand? Is there going to be a love tale at the end? Well, we certainly do not know, but the viewers seem to be quite thrilled with the announcement of the third season and, of course, with the Cinderella storyline. Jess Brownell shall assume over as showrunner for seasons 3 and 4 of Bridgerton, Netflix announced on May 14th. Paige famously left Bridgerton after season 1, citing his finished arc and one-season commitment to the show, but his new interview with Variety suggests he might be open to a cameo in the future. Since Daphne will return to the show, Rhymes doesn't say how Simon's absence will be dealt or whether he'll return in future seasons, according to reporter Angelique Jackson. That is it for today's video. Let us know in the comment section down below that who is your favorite Bridgerton character and what are your thoughts about the season 3 storyline. Do share this with your friends and family, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching this video till the end, and we will meet you in the next one.